Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode of Chow with Lau. And today I'm going to show you how to make Szechuan beef. So I'm going to show you how to make this amazing spicy, tasty dish. I'm going to introduce you to a new ingredient, the Szechuan peppercorn, which is actually not a peppercorn at all. So without further ado, let's get on with it. Right guys, so the first thing I'm going to do is prepare our beef. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to trim the fat off. I'm using a sirloin steak, and this is going to make my life easier because obviously a sirloin steak tends to be quite tender. However, you can use other cuts of beef, whatever you have to hand or whatever you want to buy. If you're gonna get one of the cheaper cuts, then you might have to velvet it. And I'll leave you a card in the corner so that you can check out my Kung Bao beef recipe, which has a technique for velveting within that. So check that one out, guys. Now, to make the most out of a steak, we're gonna cut it on a diagonal and create slices. And this will make this beef go quite a long way. So for one steak, we should be able to easily feed 2 or 3 people. Okay, if you can see what I'm doing, I'm going in at an angle and we are creating thin slices like that, which is kind of the way that the Chinese people tend to cut their meat, because traditionally we have a nice balance of meat and vegetables. It's not all about the meat. So that gives us, it makes meat go further, plus it's healthier because you eat more vegetables. Okay, so when we get into the center of the steak, the strips are getting quite long, so we can actually cut that down again. It turns one piece into 2 pieces. The other advantage, of course, of cutting the meat so thin is it cooks really, really quick. And so that enables us to stir fry things really quickly, sear things off, and everything cooks really, really quick, which is the essence of a lot of stir fry dishes. It seals in the flavor. Make sure that your vegetables don't go soggy whilst waiting for the meat to cook. And the same goes with the vegetables. We don't tend to cook our vegetables all the way through because we like that crisp texture from a stir-fried vegetable rather than kind of, you know, stewing it or anything like that. Okay, so as we're going through, we're turning one piece of beef into many pieces of beef, and that gives us this. So that's quite a lot of bites, really. So onto the veggies. For this dish, you can use basically whatever you've got in your fridge. I think onions is always definitely a good start because it provides the aromatics that we're looking for in a dish like this. It'll add to whatever flavor we've already got in the sauce. So I'm gonna kind of roughly chop it. Not too small. We want quite chunky veggies. Again, this will ensure that when it cooks and you stir fry, it keeps some crispness. We don't want it to go soggy and mushy. So peppers are also a good ingredient for a stir fry. They're not particularly hot, they're not hot at all actually, but their texture is really, really, really good for this kind of recipe because they have bite to them. And again, we don't want to be kind of putting in stuff that's too soft. We want things that hold a bit of texture, so it has a bit of bite and crunch to it, which is exactly what peppers can give us. Just going to take the seeds out as we go. There you go. Also adds a nice splash of colour, which always helps. If a dish looks attractive, that's always a bonus. Not the most important thing, but it's definitely a bonus. I'm also going to use mushrooms. I've got these chestnut mushrooms, which always look and taste nice. They've got a nice firm bite to them again, which is always good. Make sure your mushrooms are not overripe and soft and soggy and squelchy because they're awful. And again, we're going to cut them quite chunkily, which will give us that bite as we stir fry them. I love mushrooms. They just absorb the flavors that you put into the dish. And that's really, really good. If you're going to do this dish without meat, mushrooms would probably be your first go-to as the kind of star or the centerpiece of the dish. Right guys, you're gonna find your Sichuan peppercorns in packs like this. Okay, I wonder if I can get a closer. Yes, we can. That's what it looks like. They're not peppercorns at all. They are, let me just check my phone for Google. They are husks of seeds of two species of the prickly ash shrub, which is in the rue or citrus family. The pinkish red husks around the seeds are used for the Sichuan peppercorn spice, while the inner black seed is discarded as it is too gritty and would be sand-like when eaten. Okay, so we're actually eating the husks, okay? This will give us some spice, but what it's famous for, I believe, is the fact that it gives a slight sort of numbing effect to your taste buds, which kind of enhances the rest of the spice from the rest of the dish. That probably doesn't make any sense, but you have to try it to feel that benefit. So if nothing else, that's gonna make you curious and that will make you make this dish. So go do it, okay? It's not a peppercorn, that's the short story. Right guys, we are going to toast 1 teaspoon of these Sichuan peppercorns, okay. Toasting means we put it into a sort of medium pan without any oil and just kind of stir it around for a minute or two. This will just gently heat it up without burning it. Try not to burn it because you will get the burnt flavor, obviously, if you do burn it. Sounds obvious, really. What we're doing is releasing the aromas. As many things do when you heat them gently like this, the oils tend to come through, and that's where we're going to get the flavor from. Okay, so that's what we're doing. You can smell the aroma, actually. It's quite sort of, it's unusual. Yeah. I'm not trying to put you off, but it kind of smells slightly herbal, sort of herbal medicinal, if you know what I mean. Everybody turns off the video right now. But trust me, it's worth it. Okay. I think we're done. Right, so now we're gonna crush it in a pestle and mortar, okay? Now, if you don't happen to have a pestle and mortar, what you can do is stick it in the freezer bag, get a rolling pin, and give it a good old bash, okay? But all I'm gonna do is give this a good grind and crush it. This is quite therapeutic. Okay, give it a good crush. And there we go. Easy. You can smell the aroma even stronger now. It does smell a little bit like peppercorns, I suppose. Maybe that's what it got its name from, along with the vague shape of it. Apparently not related. So we're going to add the crushed Sichuan peppercorns into a bowl. Make sure we get all of it out. To this we're going to add 2 tablespoons of light soy sauce. One tablespoon of dark soy sauce. Three tablespoons of honey. half a tablespoon of sesame oil, one tablespoon of rice wine vinegar, one tablespoon of rice wine. Also going to add one tablespoon of chili garlic paste. The one I'm using is Doubanjiang, which is the same one I use in my Kung Bao dish. Okay, it's really, really, it's really, really nice. It's full of chili and garlic, and the two things really work well. So it's going to add to the Sichuan dish very nicely. So I'm going to add one tablespoon. It's kind of medium spicy. Won't blow your head off, but the more you add, obviously, the hotter it gets. So tread lightly. I'm going to add three finely diced cloves of garlic. Finely diced thumb-sized piece of ginger. If you've got a garlic press, you can use that actually. Really mince it up. Get that flavour into the sauce. And people don't tend to like the grittiness of ginger if it's in their dish. But whatever works for you. And finally, half a teaspoon of Chinese five spice. Give it a good, and I mean good, mix in. And that, guys, is your Sichuan sauce, basically. Now, you can use this as a marinade, as a spicy marinade, or you can use it as we are today, and we're gonna make a spicy stir fry. Either one works. Can't wait. Right, guys, get your woks ready. Okay, standard procedure, get your woks hot before you put the oil in. Hot pan, cold oil. Get it streaming hot. Then add about two tablespoons of oil. Swirl it around a little bit. Make sure it's up to temperature. Then, when it is really hot, we can place our beef in it. Listen out for that sizzle. No sizzle, no party. Okay, spread it out. Once you spread it out, leave it alone. Okay, let it sear. Let that caramelization begin. What you can do is we can add a bit of seasoning at this stage, a little bit of salt, not too much. There's plenty of salt in the soy sauce, in the Sichuan sauce we've made. Bit of pepper, again, not too much, just a little. Okay, once it's sat there for about 30 seconds or so, now we can turn it over. Because we've got that browning on one side, get that texture locked in, get those flavors locked in. Okay, get those, try to get all the sides sealed. Okay. Hot as you can, quick as you can. Okay, don't worry about if not every surface is sealed, it doesn't matter. As long as you got some or most of it. Okay, to that, keep the heat on really big. We're gonna add our peppers and our onions. Just let that sit, okay. Give it a second or two. And then give it a little toss. Start to, that's it, sear everything. Keep that heat on. Get the temperature get up again. This is where a wok ring really comes in handy if you've got one on your stove. And we can add our mushrooms. Look at that. Okay, can you see? There's actually a lot more vegetables in total compared to the beef. But that's how it should be. It makes these meals more economical, but healthier. And the flavour comes from everything. You know? There you go. Toss it through. Smells really nice, guys. Smell even better in a minute. Okay, the vegetables still should have a crunch. It should not be going, it shouldn't finish off soggy. Okay. Right, nearly there. Nearly to the point where we add our secret sauce. Now, at this point, you could actually, if you really like your spice, you can add these chilies to the stir fry, but you wouldn't eat them. They'll just impart even more heat to your dish. But I don't really want to go that far. Not today. Not today. The spice we've got in here is plenty enough, trust me. Right. I'm gonna add our sauce. Plunk it all in. I mean, let's pour it all in. Some more decorum. Look at that. Wow. Yeah, if you were to describe the smell, you would actually describe it as Chinese cuisine. There's something really, really kind of signature about it. It's unmistakable, couldn't be anything else. Amazing, right, there you go. And as we heat that up, the honey in it should help sort of start to caramelize, and the sauce will start to thicken on its own, but we're not gonna leave it to its own devices. What we're gonna do is I've got a corn flour slurry waiting. So it's about a tablespoon of corn flour in here in a bit of water. And then we're just gonna add it in. Not all of it, just add a little bit at a time and see what happens. Give this stir, because we don't want it too thick. Keep the heat on. As it heats up, it'll thicken. And there you go. I think we're about there, guys. Look at it. Oh, wow. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's not absolutely drowned in sauce. It's coated. It's lovely. And we're done. What was that? 4 or 5 minutes tops for the whole thing? How quick is that? There you go, guys. As I always say, get your taste buds ready. Right, guys, moment of truth. Here we go. Okay, try a piece of beef. Beef, obviously being steaks, nice and tender. I love using steak in these recipes. That is a really kind of deep flavour in this sauce. It's something unlike anything else I've cooked on the channel. It has that spiciness from the chili garlic paste, but it has that hint of the Sichuan peppercorns in it, which gives it a unique and very distinctive and actually very delicious flavour. It's very aromatic, it's quite delicate, and the sweetness from the honey kind of contrasts against the spiciness, which is nice. It's really, really, really nice, and that little numbness I told you about that goes on in your tongue, it really happens. The spice isn't totally overwhelming, it's just medium. I reckon I could take a bit more spice. If I put those dried chilies in, that would have given it some kick, some real oomph. That might have been my limit, but it's pleasantly spicy. Not going to blow your head, or it won't blow off most people's heads. But it's really, really, really nice. And the vegetables, it's a dull country. And the peppers add that sweetness to it, which is great. You could add anything you like, aubergines, courgettes, mixed vegetables, peas, carrots, that sort of thing if you want. I like to keep it simple, nice chunky vegetables, things like mushrooms that can absorb the flavour, perfect. But yeah, absolutely delicious this is. I thoroughly recommend it. And you've got to try that tongue tingling. It really works. I have no idea why it happens, but it's nice. So don't be afraid. The Szechuan peppercorns you can get from your local Asian Chinese supermarket, no problem. They're quite cheap, not expensive at all. So just look out for them. They're always there. Right, guys, so hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Hopefully you're curious about tongue tingling. Please, if you've liked this video, give us a bit of a like and a bit of a subscribe. Hit that notification bell. Give feedback to YouTube that you like my videos and they will send it out further and my channel will grow and I'll do more videos. That would be lovely. But thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Take care, guys. Bye.